Hello everyone. So in this video, I will be showing you how to insert empty values and null values in SQL. So let's get started. So I'm having here my database as NewDB, and this is my table over here. My tab is the name of my table, and I have two columns. One is R number of int type and name, which is of varchar type or string. So let me just run it. So let me just insert null value. Okay. So insert into my tab values. We put for roll number, I will just pass one. And for passing null value, you can just directly do null. That's it. So let me just run this one. I'll be getting a green mark over here. So now we just go over here and put select asterisk from my tab. So if I just run it now, I'll be getting the values as one for roll number and null for name. Okay. So for space, for empty, just a empty space, you can just go over here and you can just put double parenthesis, okay? Just double parenthesis. Just go here. This is for string, okay? This is for name, not for, it won't work for int, okay? I will also show you that. We just run it now. And if I just go select asterisk from my tab. So here you can see we have one name and one space, okay, over that. So let's suppose say, let's just insert a normal name. Put John over here. So this is not a primary key, so I'm just putting one for roll number, okay? So just go here and run it. So we have got one null, empty space, and John over there. That's fine. This is for string name. Okay. So what will happen if I just put one comma, nothing? So it's throwing error. We can't do that. I think it works for like single quotes as well. If you put single quotes like this, and if you also run this one, it will work. It's working. So if you just go over here and select value, so it's also an empty space over there. Okay. That's absolutely fine. So now let's do with the roll number, okay? So for roll number, if you just go here and put null, just go put some random alphabet, okay? So if we just run it now. So if you just go here and run it, I'll be getting null over here. And what if you put those double quotes, okay? Double quotes as we did for varchar, okay? So if I just go here and run it, so I'm getting an error. We can't do that because it's of integer value. So basically, if you put double quotes, it corresponds to a varchar or string data type. So it won't work for int or numbers. What if you try to leave that empty? Okay. So if you do that, it's showing an error. So that also won't work. So if you put try single quotes, run. So it's also throwing error. So for int type, the only way to insert a empty or null value is just put null. That's it. So you can do this only way. So we just run it again, it will work. So that's it, it's working. So these are some of the ways how you can insert empty values and null values for both integer data type column and for a string data type column. So that's it for this video. I have also done many other SQL videos, SQL interview questions, and many other programming videos in C, C++, Java, Python, and 3D animation as well as in Blender. So do check out the videos of my channel. It would be really great if you could subscribe me and support me. And thanks for watching.